Hey Siege, hey Park.
Hey Siege, hey TJ, hey Ouija. Be right back, I need to get some water. I'm thirsty. Okay, I'm back. Please don't give out your... Wait, 11 years old, but your birthday's in 2018. Well, congratulations. Well, yep, I'm doing it again, Charlie. Gonna try. So, since the last stream, I made some progress, and if you've been keeping up with the community posts or looking at the Puyo Discord, you might have seen the latest version. So, there's a couple things I want to accomplish today. I want to add touch input so this works properly on mobile devices. I need to try to get that working. Let's see. What did I do here? Pointer down. Right button down. Where's the documentation for... What are the grade options eventually supposed to be in the Puyo Select? Or the transmetrics parent. Oh, you know, maybe I should work on that. are. There's a lot of things to do today. Should I worry about the touch inputs right now? It's not like you guys can really see that. Whatever. Okay, first, what I really wanted to do was... Wait. Is this the latest update? All... Wait a second. I'm sure I had a... I was working on this on my other computer recently. Huh, let me go look at my laptop. I was working on the score set, like the score counter code. Let me go check. Hey, Calman. Okay, let me pull my latest version from GitHub. Okay, here we go. Oh, okay. So what I was doing was getting... Okay, I get the game. What I'm trying to do is get... This is to update as the chain pops. But first I need to be able to tell which digit each one needs to like turn to. So let me think about this for a second. My code for what was my so this gets the score as a string instead of just a number. This will add in the missing zeros so I can get like the right thing showing. So that has to be 8 digits, right? And then now I'm gonna loop through each of the 8 sprites and change them to the updated one. How do I do this again? I think that should do it. I have to swap out the sprites. Okay. Then... I want the score to update right before it begins, well, at the same time the popping animation begins. Let's see. Let me rename this. Okay, let's see if this works. Oh, why is that clip? That's strange. You see how the 8's lower? Oh. Darn it, I don't think I set the sprite sheet correctly. So I stole the assets right directly from Puyo Puyo Tetris, so... It's too low. Okay, I was just to fudge it a couple times. So I made a script to automatically make the sprite sheet. This is the second row. Maybe... Now that looks like it's a couple pixels too high now. Darn it. How did I have this up before? 64. 6. A new hybrid vehicle. Wow, that's amazing. Okay, good luck. Don't crash it. Hey, Hypermark. Oh my gosh, I need to look really closely at this. Do the numbers look even to you? Oh, is the 8 too low? Or am I overthinking it? Or maybe the 0 is just tall. Okay, maybe I need more numbers to look at. Let's just make the chain longer. I think this seems about right. Hey, Gecko. Yeah. I'm trying to see if I place the pixel positions of the numbers correctly. The 6 looks like it's kind of low. I don't know. It looks a little off to me. Okay, maybe I had it right before. I don't know anymore. Okay, that looks good. But I'll be playing some Puyo later on, I don't know. Okay, this is good enough. Now I need a function. I need to be able to reset the score, huh? Okay, well, that wasn't as bad. But now I want to do something else. You know how it shows the multiplication thing? to show you like the bonuses. I'm gonna try to see if I can get that to work. Let's see. So it's three digits, the X symbol, three digits. So let's see. The left hand side, that's I think that's the chain power times. Okay, I need to look up the scoring page in the wiki again. Have I been watching The Promised Neverland? Yo, it's so good. I don't know if I watched the latest episode yet. I need to catch up. I watched like the first two though, I think. So the score on the left side is the number of Puyo clear chain power in point Puyos. Oh, okay. Then I need to... add in the missing digits. I'm not sure if this is the most efficient way to be doing this stream manipulation, but it's unfair that Chronicles didn't make it in the US. Yeah, but they'll localize Persona Q too, though. Thanks, Sega. Well, actually, let me think about this for a second. It won't just show zeros, right? Do I really need to be doing this? It needs to start. Because it could be a 3, 2, or 1 digit number, but it needs to fill out the 3, like, the 3 digits from the right side. How do I do this? Actually, I need to fill out this more. Can't you use the modulus to get, like, each digit of a number? Do I need to do that? I can think of a couple ways to do this. Just try duplicate code based on. Wait. How do I do that with the modulus? Forgot. Am I making it too complicated? Okay, well, first things first, I need to. Google question. I don't really feel like reading Stack Overflow right now. You divide the number. Wait. Oh. I want... Okay, that's how you do it. Well, first, let's just set all the... Sorry, I'm just thinking. Here, let me just do this stupid way. I'm not good at doing it the smart math way, so whatever. Thanks, TypeScript. Need to do that first. Okay. If it equals just X, then add some memes in the comments of the code. I don't know. It's a lot of work. Wait. Need to offset it by one, since there's three digits, the X, three digits, and then an unused one. So... One, two, three, four, five. What are my hopes for this simulator? Well, I don't intend for this to replace the Puyo Nexus simulator by any means. This is more for when I make tutorials later. But it still has to function decently as a normal simulator. Animate ops. Okay, here's one that's flashing.
Wait, what does this do? Oh.
I made this really stupid. Oh my gosh. Okay, I just need to do this. Where's my ex? Oh. Actually, possible I didn't count pixels correctly. I didn't. I got my X and Y mixed up. Loading anymore. Not fit inside. Why is it showing the division symbol? What? No, it's supposed to be an X. Oh, I'm an idiot.
Shouldn't it be down lower? Better. Okay, that's working. Got one thing done. Let me save this. Wasn't Puyo Puyo Box the last Puyo game released by Compile? I think so. I don't know though. I'm not an expert on the IRL lore. Last decisive battle? Question mark. Oh yeah, Puyo touch. Okay, what is it gonna work on next? Oh, I need to get the chain number displaying. Thankfully, I already have some code for this, so... Huh? You can try it already if you want to. Let me see. Well, there's like the fuller old version, which is on stoolsoftener.com, and then there's the one I'm working on now, which is at 'Why am I live streaming this? I don't know, because I'm bored and lonely. I don't know. Also, everyone else is more helpful at finding bugs than I was on my own. That was pretty exciting, but today I'm doing some pretty straightforward just sprite placement things, so I'm not expecting anything to go wrong. You know, I want to talk to someone. Oh, not that kind of lonely. Just more like just fun hanging out, right? More fun than being alone. But not that being alone is bad. Hey, Lucky Nino.
Let me think. Okay. Oh wait, I already have this defined. Oh. I already had this. This is some old cult code I had from the last project, so... I'm naming this inconsistently, huh? Whoa, what happened here? Oh. That was crazy. Wait, did that? Let's set this to true for now. Oh wait, I have to actually call that. Okay. What am I working on the moment? Puyo, Wow. YouTube's moderator chat caught a message to hold for review. It says, F this web Tetris. Thank you. Why are you watching this as almost no programming experience? Well, you can learn. JavaScript is pretty simple. Oh, I'm working on displaying the chain counter now. I already have the score displays and stuff working. Now it's getting the chain counter to appear over here. I thought about getting really fancy and having the chain counter appear over different spots on the board, but then I was like, that's really hard. Because I have to calculate different spots and then like move it around. And then what happens if there's two groups popping in different locations? How do I know which one to go to? That's just too much work and thinking. And no one really cares about it that much. Okay, maybe people do, but I don't. I'm lazy. Okay. Looking at my code that I used to have, I have no idea what I did. So here's the original animation code that I wrote for the previous incarnation of the chain simulator. So like when the chain happens, the chain counter display like bounces up and down. And I think I made that animation like the bounce up and down. It's parabola. But I kind of just wrote down all these numbers. What is 225? What's 16? Oh, damn it. And this is why you don't do magic numbers to make things work. Darn. Oh, crap. Well, I'll just have to redo that. Maybe? I won't care. I'm just gonna update the number statically. I'm too tired to make things fancy right now. Whatever. Let's see. Is this going to be playable or just custom placements like the Puyo Nexus simulator? It's going to be playable. And also custom placements. I'm going to try to make it so you can toggle back and forth. That's exactly what happens to me, Charlie. It's just like, I don't know anymore. That code's unusable because it didn't comment or explain the equation I used. Well,
Okay. These long variable names. Okay. The first thing you need to get the chain links, right? Then actually, do I need to do this? Okay, displayed the three sprites, and then gotta change the textures to be the right one. This is complicated. Fine, I'll just do it this way. Okay.
That will update the sprite now. There we go. Oh. Okay, now when I reset the field, this should remove... Okay, I need to get a double digit change just to make sure this is working. Okay. How long will the stream be going for? I don't know. You know, maybe I'll try to edit the animation right now. Oh, I remember now what I was doing. Thank you.
I see.
Change colored Puyos to the first sprite, beat out garbage Puyos, then... Sorry, I'm thinking for a second.
Okay, let's see if that works. Oh. It was supposed to go back down. I see. This needs to be shorter. Darn it. Need to think through the math for a second. Oh, I see. Okay, What IDE is this? It's Visual Studio Code. Good for web design. It's not going all the way back down. That bothers me. What did I do wrong? Minus one. I'm really totally messing around right now. Okay. Why won't this work? I shouldn't be doing this, but. Oh, where did my code go? Oh no! No, not that far. Oh no. Yeah. Don't ask me why I'm doing this. That didn't do anything. Why won't this look right? Whatever, I give up. What's it doing wrong? Not falling back down all the way. I don't think it is. Okay. I need to stop worrying about it so much. That's fine looking. What do I need to do now? Okay, how about, let's see, next up are the next window, and
setting the next window, and exporting chains. Okay, I'll get to work on that.
Does that happen too fast? I'll just leave it. Okay, next Puyos. Na na puyo puyo. Na 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 na. Puyo puyo.
Oh.
What was I doing again? Oh right, the next window. First, let's get this looking correct. Oh, wait, okay. Trying to think how I shape the data of the how should I like give the next Puyos to the simulator as a string of letters. I guess I'll just do that for now. Or I could okay, here's what I'll do. Oh. Don't know what I was thinking there. So...
Sorry, I'm sick. I don't know what I'm doing.
This is gonna sound stupid, but I'm gonna call... current next Puyos.
Oh gosh.
Then I'm gonna set some default ones. I need to comment this section more. I need both play and edit. Yep. That's what I'm going for. Well. Okay, for the first pair, what's planned for sharing your own creations? I think I'm gonna try to see if I can set up a Firebase database and just have that have it index and save things there. And then I'll use like Vue.js or something in its routing to make it like read the URL you type in. Huh? Well, I do have a Python project that's on my GitHub. It's the spectator assist tool. If you know how to do the GUI programming with this with Python, and you know how to make things display on a transparent window instead of a green screen, that would be very helpful. Right now what happens is how do I show it? Well, basically, since I don't know how to make a transparent window in Windows, I have to like put it onto a green screen, display the chain counter icons on there, and then chroma key the green out, but then that looks ugly. Hey, Dre. Okay, let me just get this done. I don't know how to define the type in TypeScript for this. I'm going to be stupid and just type in any. I'm such an idiot. I really need to learn how to use TypeScript properly. Wait, what happened here? Oh. Did I upload my code to GitHub yet? Yeah. Well, if I filter out black, then I know what you're saying. I just need to experiment more with different colors, huh? I guess. Link it to you. Sure. Visual Studio Code. Where was I? Okay, placing the first pair. Is it okay for me to define it up here instead of setting it in the constructor? I have no idea how this really works. Whatever. I think I can write this as a loop. Oh! Not that much. Oh, where did it go? Okay. If this is the first pair, then I need it to have... Well, if the first pair is visually larger than the second pair in the next window. So if D equals zero, then... I don't know if I need to clear that, but I will, just so I know what I'm doing. Actually, please work. Oh. Of course it's not gonna work if I don't actually... Wait one second. I have to add the mask.
Okay, now... Why isn't it working? Cannot set property 0 if undefined. What? Okay, wait. Cannot set property 0 of undefined. Oh, I see what I did wrong. This way. Wait, is it push or append?
I'm so confused. Oh, it's work. Oh, I know what I did wrong. Whoa, what happened here? Oh, I see where I did what is wrong. Still did something wrong. Weird. What? Why won't this show up? I don't know what's going on. Why won't the green Puyo and the yellow Puyo show up? Why? Alright, but they're like really off. Where did they go wrong? How am I doing these multiple highlights? What do you mean? Oh, there's like a keyboard shortcut on Visual Studio Code. If you hold Control Alt, you can like go across multiple lines and edit them all at once. Oh, I messed it up. Or you can do Alt Click to choose positions to edit. Append adds to the end, push adds to start. Is that how it works in JavaScript? I thought it was... I know Python's different. Whoa. Is it... I just looked at what you sent me, Chewy. Oh, okay, so what happens is what Webpack does is it packs together all of the code into one JavaScript file. Well, you should be really looking at this SRC. This is like the output folder.
after Webpack does its magic. Okay, they're in place. Oh, actually, darn. Wait. That wasn't right. There we go. Okay. That doesn't look completely centered. Let me mess with this a little. Okay, this is good enough. Okay, what next? I guess I should make the next Puyo's editable, but I think I would need more. In order to understand what I'm doing with an editable next window, I need to... Let me think. So here's my plan right now. The chain simulator itself, just one single, like, chain state. That will run in this one module right here that I'm making. But then when I want to make the tutorial app, the actual one, it needs to view multiple slides, right? So I was thinking of making that in Vue.js and supplying. But do I want it to be dependent on... I need to think about this. Or I could just go for something and change it later. It'll be a hassle, but... The assist marker. That I already made that. But it's not easily usable by anyone other than me, though. editing the Python code to make it work on your own monitor, it's kind of hard. And I haven't figured out how to make it easier. Well, at least I got it to display, right? So... what should I do next? Finish the whole game. That's not the next step. Yeah. I think I might be done for today because I need to plan out how I'm going to make, like... So I've completed what the game should all set up and be look like. How it should all be arranged, the layout. Stuff like that. Actually, there's one animation I hadn't made yet. I need to make it so that the next Puyos... I need to animate the next Puyo movement. That's one last thing I still have to do. You're calling me. Oh, I thought you knew my phone number in real life. I was a little scared there. Okay, I need to animate the next windows. Let's see what I can do. Do we know how fast the next windows move? Like the frame data for that? Rotation, drop speed, air split speed. Oh, I'm gonna have to BS this. I'll set it to 8 frames long.
Hmm? Sorry, I'm a little busy right now with this. Okay. Where did I code this originally? This looks like it makes no sense. I have an idea though. You know what? And let me try this. This is how much the first pair will move up out of the next window. Oh, I forgot. This is one of my favorite tracks. So pure. Why don't move it? I'm not sure if I really want to commit to doing it this way. I should have it like track frame count. Well, let's just see if this works. Wait, how do I call this outside of the... Oh, it went down instead of up. I'm an idiot. What? Oh. I'm gonna have to deal with these squiggly lines for a bit. Huh?
Let me think. Okay. I'm alright. Okay, each pair moves differently. So, oh gosh, god dang it. Whatever. Just gonna do them all separately. This is a hassle. But because they're different sizes too. Yeah, I'll just do it this way. Okay, here's the second pair. Gotta leave a note for myself when I inevitably mess it up later. have to make this grow back to... the original size. I have to also move it to the left. Okay, and then I have to move third Puyo there. Okay, here it goes. Wait, reload prevented. Oh. Property 0 is undefined.
Oh, I see what's happening. It's trying to set that before the game is loaded. Oh. Okay, I'll just fudge this. I'll make this run like 5 seconds in. Then there shouldn't be any complaints, right? Four, five. Move! Whoa! No, that's not where Okay. That was not planned. Oh, I see. I didn't make it stop. One, two, three, four. Oh. The yellow Puyos don't look like they moved correctly. I know why. Because the difference between the different the height at before and after scaling it. This is not going to make any sense when I view it later. Type in some magic numbers, you know? Okay, that looks fine. Let me turn the mask back on. Wait a second, that doesn't look fine. Oh, I see, I messed it up again. Oh my god! I hate myself so much. Okay, cool. That looks like correct. Okay. Now that I have this done, I also need a function that can set new next Puyos. Because I don't have the target for what it should update to yet, because I haven't decided yet on how I'm going to do, you know, a game that actually plays. How is each step going to be represented? Okay, I'm gonna leave this for another day. I quit. I think I made a lot of progress. Let's see, let me commit this. I'm gonna take a break for like 10 minutes and then come back and play some Smash for like an hour or so. All right, see you guys in a bit.